Hey guys, I'm happy that you are here. My name is Betchoy and I am your plant tito from Mindanao. Tara at samahan niyo ako sa aking plant journey. To those who are new to this channel, especially sa mga hindi pa nakapag-subscribe, please click on our subscribe button and click on the bell notification as well para maging updated kayo sa ating mga latest uploads. And also guys, please follow me on our other social media accounts. So that's aside from YouTube, we have a Facebook page and our page is Betchoy Vlog, and we also have an Instagram account and our ID is Betchoy_vlog, and let's talk about plants. So for our video today guys, this will be a care tip and propagation video about our Alocasia Green Shield. So this is our Alocasia clypeolata, or commonly known as Alocasia Green Shield, minsan ding tinatawag na Alocasia Melon because of the color of its leaves that resembles to that of a watermelon. But it's really widely known as Alocasia Green Shield because of its green color and it somewhat resembles to that of a shield. So this is one of the most common alocasia na plant dito sa Philippines, alongside with the black velvet, the sinuata, and many other alocasias dito. So isa talaga ito sa pinaka-common alocasia. So considering that our Alocasia Green Shield is a very common plant dito sa Philippines, we can also expect that this is a very affordable plant. So I just don't know right now kung magkano na ito, but this is really affordable guys, and I think you can buy at around 100 pesos, 200 pesos, and you will have a very beautiful green shield. And as for my green shield, I got this one as a gift from one of my staff last year. So if you have seen my previous video, I think that was 11 or 12 months ago, yung pinakaunang plant vlog ko talaga guys, makikita ninyo doon yung itsura ng ating green shield na sobra niya pang cute. Meron pa lang atang dalawang dahon that time at saka anliit pa niya guys. So after almost a year of taking care of our Alocasia Green Shield, ito na siya guys, nakapag-reward na siya sa akin ng malalaking mga dahon, and ilang beses na rin ako nakapag-propagate ng ating green shield. So ngayon, meron tayong 7 beautiful leaves here na malalaki na, and then I think the biggest one, and this is the newest leaf here. This is almost a foot na yung kanyang size, and dito, let me just share it with you. Ito na yung ating baby na Alocasia Green Shield that is ready for propagation. So ipopropagate natin ito later on in our video. So in this video, I will be sharing with you how do I take care of my Alocasia Green Shield. And also, later on, I'll be sharing some tips on how we can grow our Alocasias na ganito na sila kalalaki. And huwag din natin kalimutan yung propagation video, papakita ko din sa inyo later on. And also, I would like to share lang din that I think for most of my alocasia ng mga plants, not entirely 100% naman, pero most of them talagang medyo nakuha ko talaga yung ano yung mga tricks na dapat natin gawin para mas mapalaki natin sila. And in our care tips video today, we'll just be dividing it into 5 parts. The first one will be our lighting requirements, second will be the watering needs, third and the fourth will be our soil mix and fertilizer being used, and the fifth one will be the pesticide. So I specifically included pesticide and some insecticides and fungicides for this episode guys, kasi yung ating mga alocasia, they have these such soft leaves, malambot yung kanilang mga dahon, at talagang lapitin sila sa mga peste guys, and that includes yung mga higad. So for our Alocasia Green Shield, I specifically place it in an area na bright and shaded. So let me just emphasize guys, that's bright and shaded, wala siyang direct sunlight except for morning sunlight. So right now, I'm placing my green shield sa area na malapit sa aking nursery area kung saan that's shaded by a gardenette, and at the same time, it's also shaded by this rambutan tree in my back. And I think it's already a general knowledge to everyone that most of our Alocasia plants talaga, they do not prefer direct sunlight kasi they have such very soft leaves, napakalambot na kanilang mga dahon, and it's very fragile. So they can only tolerate yung morning sunlight, at pupwede din sila actually ng filtered sun. So what are the threats ba kung i-overexpose natin sa sunlight yung ating green shield? Yung pinaka-problem natin talaga dyan guys is yung pagkakaroon ng sunburn. And how do we know kung nagsasunburn na yung ating green shield? So malalaman natin yun kapag nagsistart ng mag-yellow yung ibang spots ng ating mga dahon. So from the yellowing, it will eventually turn into browning. And ang mangyayari na niyan is magkakaroon na ng butas yung ating mga dahon. So unlike our other alocasia such as the alocasia black velvet na merong makakapal na mga dahon, perhaps they can tolerate a little bit more of sunlight, pero yung ating mga green shield kasi, they have very thin leaves and it's very soft guys and it's very fragile, so they really cannot tolerate being overexposed to sunlight. And let me just emphasize guys that if ever we subject our green shield sa morning sunlight, it should be only up to 8 a.m. and not beyond 8 a.m. kasi sobrang mainit na yun para sa ating plant. So if you would ask me guys, would you recommend placing our green shield indoors? Yung pinaka-answer ko talaga dyan is that I do not recommend na ilagay natin ito sa indoors kasi sa akin, I'm placing most of my plants outdoors. So the reason to that is that kung sa indoors kasi natin ilagay yung ating mga plants, there is that limited supply of light talaga. So alam naman natin na yung ating mga alocasia, including our green shield, medyo matakaw sila sa light. And if we consider its natural habitat also, it's in the outdoors and then nasa wild sila. So talagang meron tayong steady supply of bright and indirect light all throughout the day. So if ever, kung hindi talaga mapipigilan at gustong-gusto ninyong ilagay sa indoors yung ating mga green shield, I recommend and I suggest na lagyan nyo na lang or gamitan ninyo na grow lights para ma-supplement natin yung kanyang lighting requirement. Also, you can place them in an area na malapit sa mga pintuan or sa mga bintana kung saan meron silang access sa bright light. So, meron namang mga bagay na dapat nating bantayan kapag nagkukulang naman yung lighting na nakukuha na ating mga green shield. Number one is that they produce mga maliliit na mga dahon. So, that would mean na hindi talaga enough yung lighting na nakukuha ng ating plant kasi hindi na sila lumalaki. Number two is that kung kapag nagiging leggy na yung ating mga alocasia green shield. So, when I say leggy, it's actually a bit relative. So, if we compare with its previous leaves, nagiging mahaba na yung kanyang mga stem or yung kanyang mga petiole because it's trying to reach out for that area na merong source of light. Third sign naman is kapag nakikita na natin na medyo faded na yung color ng ating green shield. So, instead of seeing a medyo dark green, nagsistart na siyang maging fade or medyo nagiging light green na siya as compared with its previous leaves, pwera na lang sa pinakabagong dahon kasi it's really expected na medyo lighter talaga yung kanyang pagka-green as compared with the mature leaves. Another sign na dapat natin bantayan na na-underexpose na sa light yung ating green shield is kapag nagiging mabagal na yung kanyang pag-produce ng mga dahon. So, if previously you noticed na every month siya nagpo-produce ng mga dahon and then suddenly, nagdalawang buwan na at hindi pa siya nakapag-produce ng dahon, then it's also a sign na baka underexposed sa light yung ating green shield. So guys, if ever you see this sign sa ating mga alocasia green shield, I recommend na immediately i-place natin sila outdoors kung saan it's bright and shaded para makakuha sila ng enough lighting. Kung sa indoors naman and na-place nyo na sila sa area na malapit sa bintana or sa doors and it's still growing like that, it's highly recommended na lagyan na lang natin ng grow lights para ma-supplement natin yung kanyang lighting needs. And also, if ever sa indoors natin nilagay yung ating green shield, I also recommend na ilabas din natin sila from time to time, siguro once a week or twice a week, para naman makakuha sila ng natural lighting. And by the way guys, bigla ko lang naalala, regarding our green shield pala na i-expose natin sa morning sunlight, this is actually applicable lang sa ating mga green shield na stable and well-rooted. So, kapag kakaripat lang natin sa kanila or kakapropagate lang, I would not recommend na expose natin sila sa even sa morning sunlight. So, we just have to place them in an area na bright and shaded, walang direct sunlight para hindi ma-stress yung ating plant. And maybe we'll just have to wait for at least 3 to 4 weeks para mapastabilize natin yung ating plant. And I also have this one tip pala guys regarding the spread of our green shield ng mga dahon. So kung gusto, if ever gusto ninyo na widely distributed yung ating mga dahon, such as this one na merong nakaharap dito, meron din dun sa likod, I recommend na i-rotate natin yung ating plant from time to time para maging even yung kanyang distribution. So if ever naman guys na gusto ninyo na front-facing or one-sided lang yung direction ng ating mga dahon, then it's no longer necessary na i-rotate natin yung ating green shield. So meron din ako isang recommendation guys para sa development ng ating green shield, and that is to shower our leaves or linisin natin yung kanyang mga dahon from time to time, siguro once a week or once in every 2 weeks, para mas magkaroon talaga siya ng clear access to the light or to the sunlight. Kasi kapag masyado na siyang maraming alikabok or may mga dirt dito sa kanyang mga dahon, parang ma-filter or matatabunan yung light na kanyang ma-absorb. And it's also a way for us to remove the pest na namamahay dito sa ating mga dahon. So, if ever you'd ask me guys if it's okay to use leaf cleaners, yung position ko naman yan, it's actually it's okay. Just as long as we use the water-based na mga leaf cleaners. Kasi kapag water-based, that would be very easy for our plant na i-wash off lang yan kapag i-water natin. And then, it will be gone. Kapag kasi oil-based yung gagamitin ng mga leaf cleaners, meron siyang chance na ma-clog yung stomata ng ating plant. So baka mahirapan mag-absorb ng lighting yung ating mga dahon. So to summarize everything about the lighting requirements of our Alocasia Green Shield, yung lighting talaga guys, it plays a vital role on the development of our plant. So again, it's very important na ilagay natin sila sa area na bright and shaded. Morning sun is okay but only up to 8 a.m. So that's it for our lighting requirements and we can now proceed to the second requirement natin and that's for the watering needs of our green shield. So for my Alocasia Green Shield guys, wala naman akong regular scheduling in watering it. Depende, may minsan once a week or twice a week depending on the weather and the soil condition of our soil mix. So malaking factor talaga yung weather conditions natin kung kailan tayo magwa-water na ating mga Alocasia Green Shield. So if ever maulan yung panahon all throughout the week, then there's no need for us to water our Alocasia. Kapag naman medyo mainit yung panahon all throughout the week, then we can expect na baka maging frequent din yung pag-water ng ating Alocasia Green Shield. What I have also noticed with my Green Shield and most of my Alocasias is that medyo mas gusto nila na medyo moist or malamig yung kanilang soil environment. And before I decide to water my Alocasia Green Shield, I need to make sure and check on its soil condition first. So yung unang-unang gagawin ko talaga guys is I do the finger test and make sure that the first top inch of our soil mix is totally dried out before I decide to water my green shield. One thing that we also need to take note guys, if ever magwa-water tayo na ating mga Alocasia Green Shield, we need to make sure that in between watering, dapat hindi totally dried out yung ating soil. Kasi kapag na-underwater naman natin yung ating green shield, that would be very stressful to our plant. So what are the signs na underwater na natin yung ating green shield? Yung pinakauna talaga is kapag titignan pa lang natin yung kanyang soil mix, especially yung kanyang topsoil, makikita natin na dry na talaga siya. And then another sign would be kapag nakikita natin na yung kanyang mga dahon ay nagda-drop na or nagiging droopy or nagiging matamlay. So if ever you notice these signs with our Alocasia Green Shield, immediately dapat i-water lang natin sila and then we should not be worrying lang kasi mabilis lang naman sila makarecover. So we were talking about underwatering being a problem with our Alocasia Green Shield. Yung overwatering naman guys, that's another big problem to our plant. So what are the signs na dapat nating bantayan kung nag-overwater na tayo sa ating mga Green Shield? Number one is kapag nagiging yellow na yung mga tips natin mga dahon and eventually our leaves would turn mushy. Number two is kapag nagiging droopy na siya or nagiging matamlay, and then after natin ma-suspect or ma-check yung mga signs na ito, immediately i-uproot natin yung ating plant and then makikita natin na slowly na pala nag-root rot or nag-uumpisa ng mabulok yung mga ugat ng ating Alocasia Green Shield. So kapag nag-root rot na yung ating Alocasia Green Shield, ang manonotice natin dyan guys is meron na siyang mga parts ng roots niya na nagiging mushy na, yung parang jelly-like na yung kanyang substance and then nagsistart na siyang mga amoy or meron ng mga rotten smell. So what we need to do is to remove the parts na may mga rotten portions na and then i-repot natin yung ating green shield. And pinaka number one talaga natin take note guys is dapat hindi natin i-recycle yung ating soil mix. We need to totally change the soil mix of our Alocasia Green Shield. So when I water my Alocasia Green Shield guys, I make sure that they get enough water that they really need. I do full watering sa ating topsoil and I make sure that evenly yung pag-distribute natin ng water. And then until such time na makita ko nag-drain na yung ating water from our potholes, then that's the time na enough na yung water na naibibigay natin sa ating soil mix. Actually guys, meron pa na isang factor that can really affect the soil condition of our soil mix and that is the pot size na ating ginagamit. So for my Alocasia Green Shield and most of my Alocasias in general, I use a relatively small pot para hindi magtagal yung water dito sa ating potting mix at saka mas mabilis siyang mag-dry out. Because if we use a relatively big na pot for the plant natin, for its root system, ang mangyayari is that number one, medyo matatagalan yung pag-dry out ng ating soil mix and then there's a chance na baka mag-develop ito ng root rotting kasi nga, medyo matagal mag-sit in yung water dun sa ating soil mix. Number two, ang mangyayari is kapag medyo malaki naman yung pot na gagamitin natin, yung ating plant, it will concentrate more on producing more roots instead of producing new leaves for our plant. So just like my Alocasia Green Shield guys, you can clearly see here na yung ating plant, it's already enormous in size, but then yung ating pot na ginagamit is relatively small. And also guys, it's very important for us that if ever we choose pots for our green shield, for our allocations and any other plans in general, it's very important na dapat meron itong mga potholes para makasupport ng water drainage. And by the way guys, yung ating mga alocasia green shields and other alocasias in general, they love to be in a place na may high in humidity. So what I do is that I group my alocasia green shield together with other plants, so it's like they're creating their own microenvironment na may high in humidity. So there are many ways for us to increase the humidity in a microenvironment kung saan nakalagay yung ating mga plants. And number one would be regular misting. So if ever medyo mainit yung panahon, we can actually do misting at least twice a day, once in the morning and then once in the afternoon. And then there's also another way for us to parang i-increase din yung humidity ng ating mga plant, and that is to use a humidity plate. So meron tayong plate dito sa ilalim na may mga pebbles or may mga marbles or may mga stones na merong water doon sa kanyang ilalim na parang ka-layer na niya yung mga pebbles, and then we place our plant on top of that humidity plate. And if ever naman medyo mahirap yung dalawa gawin, yung ating misting tsaka yung humidity plate, what we can do, especially kung nasa outdoors yung ating mga plants, is that basahin natin yung surroundings ng ating plant kung saan sila nakalagay. Ang mayayari niyan is that yung water na andun sa soil natin or sa ground, slowly mag-evaporate lang ito, and then that will provide the humidity needed by our plant. So to summarize the watering needs of our alocasia green shield, number one, wala talagang regular na schedule of watering it. It still depends on the weather and the soil condition of our green shield. So we need to make sure that the first top inch is totally dried before we water it. And then, dapat hindi lang din natin i-underwater ito. Dapat hindi siya totally dried out in between watering. And also, dapat wala ding overwatering kasi makakasira ito sa ating plant. So now, we may now proceed sa ating soil mix na ginagamit sa ating alocasia green shield. So what are the characteristics needed by the soil mix for our alocasia green shield? Number one, mas gusto nila na medyo compact feel yung kanilang soil mix. Number two, dapat it can also hold moisture. But take note lang guys, it's just moisture na hindi talaga totally na mag-sit in yung water sa ating pot. Number three, it's very important that it's also well-draining. And number four, it should have the nutrients that it needs for development. So what are the components of my soil mix? I only use three components para sa ating soil mix. And the first one is our loam soil, and it comprises 60%. So ano ba yung loam soil natin guys? It's just the typical brown soil or the black soil that we can find from outside our houses. At ito na yung magpro-provide ng compact fields for our root system na ating alocasia green shield. And at the same time, this will also hold moisture for our plant. The next component is our pumice. And this will help and promote water drainage ating soil mix. Yan talaga yung importance ng ating pumice guys, ang makatulong sa pag-drain ng water para hindi mag-sit in yung water dun sa ating soil mix. So if ever wala tayong pumice, then we can use small stones naman as substitute for our pumice. And our third component would be our fertilizer. And in my case naman, I'm using vermicast, and that will comprise 20% by volume. So actually guys, I'm more into using mga organic na mga fertilizers. So if ever walang available na vermicast or yung worm casting, we can use animal's manure from horse, from cow, from goat. Just need to make sure na hindi pa siya fresh guys ha. Dapat yung dried na or compost na para pwede na natin silang gamitin. So if ever we are already using yung ating mga organic na mga fertilizers, there's no need for us to add mga osmocoat or yung mga chemical-based na mga fertilizers kasi ma-overfeed na yung ating plant. At ang mangyayari niyan, kapag na-overfertilize natin, ay magkakaroon na ng mga sunog-sunog na parts yung ating mga dahon. Kung magta-top up naman tayo ng ating fertilizer, guys, so again, in my case, I'm using yung ating vermicast. I just use a handful of my vermicast and then at least once every 2 months or every quarter yung ating pag-top up. So that's it for our soil mix and fertilizer being used, and we may now proceed sa ating fifth na ginagamit, at that is our pesticide. So for my pesticide, I generally use yung ating neem oil for all of my plants. So timing na timing guys, kasi kakakuha lang natin ng ating leafy pests away. So this is our organic pesticide with neem extract. So tamang-tama talaga guys, kasi mas preferred kong gumamit ng mga organic na mga pesticides over the chemical based na mga pesticides. So this one, this is from Leafy PH, and Again, this is our leafy pest away. So yung gagawin lang natin, hindi na natin ito kailangan i-mix pa kasi this is already pre-mixed. So we'll just have to shake this one and then spray it on our leaves and our petioles and on our soil mix. So for our neem oil na pesticide, I use this one at least once a week lang for management lang or for prevention. Pero if ever makakakita ako ng mga infestations in some of my plants, so I use it at least twice a week. So what I really love about our leafy pest away, guys, kasi hindi siya masangsang, hindi mabaho yung kanyang amoy. Unlike nung previous na ginagawa ko na ako yung nagmi-mix ng neem oil extract with the detergent and the water, medyo masakit talaga siya ilong. Pero this one, we still need to use face mask, by the way, pero hindi talaga siya masakit sa ilong. So that's it for our pesticide being used, and we may now proceed sa ating quick propagation ng ating green shield. So ito na, guys, yung ating closer look ng ating Alocasia green shield sa kanyang soil mix. So ito, makikita natin na meron na dito mga bulbs and then mga different growth points na lumalabas from our Alocasia green shield. Napakarami na rin nila dito, guys. And then we have this one baby plant here na meron ng 2 leaves. Actually, napaka-healthy na ng kanyang mga dahon dito. At ito yung ipopropagate natin today. So, by the way, sa mga bulbs na ito na makikita natin, dito na tumutubo yung mga panibagong plants. And by the way, guys, before I decide to propagate our green shield na Alocasia, I make sure na meron na tayong at least 2 mature na mga dahon before natin sila kukunin. Well, actually, guys, there are 2 ways for us to propagate our Alocasia green shield. And the first one is to totally uproot our plant and to separate the baby plants from the mother plant. And the second one is yung medyo mabilis lang, and that is yung dukutin lang natin yung ating plant. So yan yung gagawin natin ngayon. So guys, we will be doing the second method. So ang gagawin lang natin is ipapasok natin yung ating kamay dun sa ating soil, and then itry natin i-feel kung nasaan yung bulbs, and then trace it hanggang sa ma-feel din natin yung kanyang mga ugat. And then slowly, we will pull out the plant including the bulb and the roots. So from there, dito makikita na natin na meron na tayong separate plant with its own bulb and root system. So ganito lang ka-easy mag-propagate ng ating Alocasia green shield, guys. And the next thing that we need to do is to repot our baby plant sa soil mix na na-mention natin earlier on. And of course, dapat relatively small pa yung pot na gagamitin natin. And by the way, for our newly propagated na plant, dapat bright and shaded area lang muna siya, guys. Walang direct morning sunlight. And wala munang watering in the next 2 to 3 days. So that would be it, guys. That would be our care tip and propagation video for our green shield. And I hope na meron din kayong natutunan sa ating episode today. And before we end our video, let us do our shoutouts. Shoutout kay Sir Tony Evangelista. Shoutout din kay Suprema Aruray. Shoutout also to Jillian LeBlanc. Shoutout to Ma'am Teresa Bayon. Hi and good day to Rina Agnes. Shoutout also to Ma'am Connie Marasigan. Shoutout as well to Maralina Zarate. Shoutout na rin kay Ginaline Acha. Shoutout also to Kelvin Maagad. Shoutout din kay Ma'am Alice Alma Bungay. And shoutout kay Ma'am Marilyn Ortelio. So guys, if you happen to like our videos, please don't forget to like, share to your families, friends, loved ones, and friends. And if ever bago ka pa lang sa ating channel, please don't forget to subscribe and click on our bell notification para maging updated kayo sa ating mga latest uploads. Once again, this is Betchoy, your plantito from Mindanao. Happy planting!